In this week's Parsha, Parshas Vayigash, we read about Yaakov Avinu's arrival to Mitzrayim. Yaakov comes to Egypt, Yaakov comes to Mitzrayim, and his arrival wasn't only visible by all the Mitzrayim, by all the Egyptians, but it also was palpable. They actually felt physically, they knew that Yaakov Avinu was there. Rashi comments in Perek Mem Zayin Pasuk Yud Tes, chapter 47, verse 19, Rashi tells us, V'sen zera lizroa ha'adama, va'afal pisha omar Yosef va'od chamei shonim, asher ein chorish v'kotzer. Even though Yosef taught us, and Yosef told us just a few psukim back, that there's not going to be harvesting, there's not going to be plowing, and there will be a famine for an additional 5 years. Mikevan, Sheba Yaakov l'Mitzrayim, since Yaakov Avinu, since the patriarch Jacob arrived in Mitzrayim in Egypt, ba'o bracha l'ragla v'hischilo l'zroa. So then bracha came, blessing came to Mitzrayim, and the famine ended. Everything was over. It was initially decreed that the famine should be, the ra'av should be, for a total of 7 years. However, Yaakov Avinu arrived in Mitzrayim the second year, and there were 5 more years left to the family, left to the ra'av. However, everything stopped, and it was over because of the arrival of the tzaddik of Yaakov Avinu. So they actually knew and they felt that Yaakov was there in Mitzrayim. My grandfather, blessed memory, notes, has a wonderful observation that the psukim, the verses and the text of last week's portion, last week's parsha of Miketz, actually supports this idea. We know that Paro had a dream that there were going to be 7 healthy cows, and then the 7 emaciated and ugly cows ate the 7 healthy cows. If we look at the psukim, we'll see something very interesting. The pasuk tells us vatochalna haparos ra'os hamare, that the ugly and the thin and the emaciated cows, vidakos habasar, ace sheva haparos, they ate the 7 Yefos Mara Fabrios, cows that were healthy and beautiful. When speaking about the ugly, emaciated, thin cows, it doesn't say 7. It doesn't say sheva. It says Vatochalna Haparos Ra'os Hamare Vidakos Habasar Ace Sheva Haparos Yefos Hamare. It doesn't say 7 when speaking about the ugly and emaciated cows. It only says 7 when we're speaking about the healthy and the good-looking and the beautiful cows. Same true when speaking about the stalks, when we talk about the ears, when the thin ears that swallowed up the 7 healthy ears, it doesn't say sheva in the pasuk. It merely says, Vativlana hashibolim hadakos ace sheva hashibolim. When speaking about the thin ears, it doesn't say the number, it is not quantified, we do not use the number sheva. However, when speaking about the healthy and the full ears, then again we do say ace sheva hashibolim. Why? Because this was never realized. The 7 years of ra'av, this is all allegorical. This dream represents the future of Mitzrayim, that there was going to be a famine, and there was going to be 7 years of famine. Of course, it also represents the 7 years of abundance, 7 years of plentiful, that was going to have much food, much growth. However, also it represents the 7 years of famine. The 7 years of famine was never actually realized. It didn't happen, because when Yaakov Avinu came to Mitzrayim, the zchus that everyone had upon his arrival, the famine stopped, as we see in this week's parsha, that was only for 2 years and not for 7 years. It ended, and these psukim seem to imply that as well.